Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and today I'll show you how to use the boundary surface command in Solidworks. This would be practice exercise 30 of this playlist, and I will provide its file in the description link. So let's go to a new, select part and select OK. And now we are in Solidworks interface. So first of all, as usual, I will change my background to plain white, and I will set my units to mmgs. Okay, so let's make a straight slot here, and I'll go to the top plane, select sketch, and I'll go to your center point straight slot, and I will make one slot here. Okay, let's dimension this slot. Let's say this dimension is 150 millimeters, that is pitch, and let's say this width is 100 millimeter. Okay, and now you can see that this sketch is fully defined. So let's exit this sketch, and now I will create a reference plane. So let's go to your reference plane, select plane, and for the first reference I will select top plane, and I will change this distance to, let's say, 70 millimeters. Okay, let's select this plane, select sketch, view normal, and I will make one circle here. Okay, and let's say this dimension from this origin to this center point is let's say 40 millimeters, and let's say this diameter is 60 millimeters, and you can see that this sketch is also fully defined. Let's exit this sketch, and now you can see that we have two sketches. So I will hide this plane, and now I will draw the front profile. So let's go to your front plane, select sketch, view normal, and I will make two splines here, one spline here and another spline here. Now I will join my spline with this circle and with this slot. So just rotate it, and I will select this point, and I will select this circle, and I will select this option, make tiers. Similarly, select this point, hold control key, select this arc, and select this option, make tiers. Similarly, this point, this circle, tiers, this point, this arc, and tiers. Okay, now I will use this view. This is a spline. I will drag this handle to here, and I will use this one horizontal. Similarly, this one vertical. And let's say I will give some dimensions to this one, this handle. Let's say this dimension is 200 millimeters, and let's say this one is 150. Similarly, this handle would be horizontal, and this handle would be vertical. And let's say this dimension is 150, and this one is, let's say, 100 millimeters, and exit this sketch. So front profile is ready, and now I will draw this right profile. So for this I have to make another reference plane, because this center point is not our origin. So let's go to your reference plane, select plane. For the first reference I will use right plane, and for the second reference I will use this point. Okay, now I will draw this profile. So select sketch, view normal. Here I will only draw one profile here, and I will mirror it. Okay, so let's go to your spline. I will draw one random spline here, and I will rotate my model. I will select this point, I will select this circle, pierce. Similarly, this point and this line, pierce. And I will drag this, and I will give them relation called horizontal, and similarly this one, vertical. Now here I will use mirror relation. I will draw one center line. Let's dimension these handles. So let's say this dimension is 70, and let's say this dimension is also 70. Here I can use the symmetric relation. I'll go to a mirror entities, entities to mirror this one, mirror about the center line, and select OK. You can see this preview, and you can see that this sketch and this sketch is fully defined. You can see here as well. Just exit this sketch, and also I will hide this plane. And now I can use my boundary surface command. If you don't find this surfaces tab, just right click, go to your tabs, and now you can check this surfaces. Now I'll go to your boundary surface. For the direction one, I will use this circle and I will use this slot. And now you can see that this surface is generated, but that is not we want. So I'll go to your directions two, which is for guide curves. And first I will use this front profile. So I will use this one, select OK. And now I will use this one, select OK. Similarly, for the side profile or right profile, I will use this one, select OK. Similarly, this one, and select OK. And now you can see that this boundary surface is generated using these curves. Here you can use these relations, which are very important. The direction to vector, normal to profile. But I will not use these relations here. Just select OK. And now your boundary surface is created. Here I will show you a very important option here. So just go to here, evaluate. And you can use this option, zebra stripes, to check the surface quality. And also you can use this option, curvature. Just click this one. Now you can see that this option, curvature. You can use this when you are dealing with quality surfaces. Now next is, I will use a command, thicken, to change this from surface bodies to solid bodies, because in reality you have solid bodies. So let's go to your thicken command. If you have one or more surfaces, so you can use this option, knit surfaces, to combine surfaces first and then use thicken option. So here we have only one surface body, so I will use this thicken option directly. So click here, thicken, select this, and I will change this thickness to, let's say, 1 millimeter from both sides, from one side only or from back side. So I will use this one, thickness from both sides, that is 0.5 millimeter up and 0.5 millimeter down. And now you can see that this surface body is converted into solid body. You can use this option, section view as well, to check this. Now I will use some appearance. Just go to your appearance, and let's say I'll go to your metal, and under metal, let's say I will use this one, brass. So that's how you create a boundary surface in SolidWorks. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any question, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting videos. Thank you.